And then we'll do initial and final values problem. The initial value and final value properties allow us to find the initial value f0 and the final value f infinity of a function directly from its Laplace transform fs. So let's see, this is the theorem for initial value, that if you have to find f or the value of the function at time t is equal to 0, you have to take limit of s approaching infinity s fs. And you have for final value theorem, its opposite, f infinity is now limit x to 0. So note, for 0 we are taking the limit to infinity, and for infinity we are taking the limit to 0 s fx. And one more thing, for the final value to be valid, the poles have to be on the left hand side. So we'll see what are the poles in the when we do the examples. Okay, so let's solve a problem with the initial and final value. This is the function given, and we have to find initial value and the function final value. So this is already in the Laplace form, transformed. So the initial condition, we have learned this formula for h0, we put limit tending to infinity. So this is the function, this was the function, hs, we multiply by s, so multiply by s, this becomes the function. And now to put s is equal to infinity, we divide by s square here, both sides by s. So this becomes in this form, and now we can put the value of infinity, so this becomes 0. Similarly, other terms also become 0. So h0 is equal to 0. Now, for the final value theorem, it is a must that we should verify whether the poles are on the left-hand side or not. Now, what are poles? If you don't remember, poles are the when the we put the denominators equal to 0, then the value that we obtain, that is the pole value. So like here, s plus 3 is equal to 0, that means s is equal to -3. So this is -3, we put across here, so this is one of the pole. And if you solve this quadratic equation, you can find the value of the other two poles. It is -4 plus j3. So this is one pole, and the other pole is -4 minus j3. So these are the three poles, and all poles are on the left hand side. So that means the final value exists, or final value theorem is applicable. So to get the final value, now we just put the value of s is equal to 0 in the given equation. So by putting s is equal to 0, again we get all values 0, so final values is also 0. Now this will give you some idea as to how to find initial value and final value values of a function. Thank you.